Pope Francis has arrived in Mozambique. It's the start of his week-long trip to southern Africa. He's the first pope to visit the country since St. John Paul II in 1988. His arrival comes at an important time for the country. Over the summer, the ruling party and armed opposition signed a new peace deal. It would end years of periodic fighting after a civil war killed an estimated 1 million people. Mozambique also was devastated by two cyclones earlier this year that left more than 650 dead. Father Don Bosco Anyala, editor-in-chief of ASI Africa, joins us from Maputo, Mozambique. Father, the Pope just landed there in Mozambique. What's the mood like?
It is a mood of excitement, joy, happiness. People started gathering late in the afternoon, hundreds inside the airport, thousands on the streets, on the roads leading to the airport. The Pope has been greeted here in Maputo, Mozambique, by cheers, by song, by dance. And so it is a mood of great excitement.
So there's lots of excitement, but also, as we just heard, this trip comes as an important time for the country. Do you really think the Pope can help with the peace process?
Well, there is a lot of expectation among the people that I've talked to. I arrived here 3 days ago, and I've been discussing and talking about the Pope's visit with the members of the clergy, the religious, and the lay faithful. And yes, they are expecting the Pope to cement the peace agreement, the peace accord that has been signed. There is a lot of longing for a lasting peace in the country. And they are hoping that in terms of the Holy Father coming here, he will be able to emphasize, to restate the value of peaceful coexistence, and that faith in people can help them live together.
It's so important in a country that has suffered for so long in civil war. So, like I said, you have a lot on his plate for Mozambique. What else is on the agenda for the Holy Father during his visit?
Well, he is going to meet various groups, among them the political class. He is scheduled to meet the president tomorrow. He will also meet members of the diplomatic corps, but also meet with the religious, the clergy, catechists, and also the young people. And one thing that has had an impact on this country is the cyclone that devastated the country with lives that were lost and property destroyed. And people felt like they were angry with nature, but also with God. And so they're looking at the Pope's coming as an assurance they can have that God did not punish them. God still loves them, and that there is hope, and that there can be peace, and that it can be reconciliation, not only with themselves and among themselves and with God, but also with nature.
Remind us, Father Don Bosco, you have been talking to us about why the Pope wanted to come to Africa. What was his incentive?
Well, I think he has targeted countries in Africa that are undergoing some kind of conflict, some kind of trouble, some kind of misunderstandings among the people, and that his coming has usually come as an assurance that he, as a leader for the Catholic faithful around the world, cares about Africa, cares about the faith growth in Africa. Africa represents the future of the church, because here populations are high and growing, and the faith seems to be on a steadfast growth. And so he has come to reassure the church in Africa, the people of God in Africa, that he cares for them.
Okay, and obviously we'll encourage our followers with EWTN to continue to stay with us as we follow the Pope this week. Father Don Bosco Anyala, editor-in-chief of EWTN's ASI Africa, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.